What's up, everybody? General Guyble here. Actually, I wanted to make a video in the studio with like this kind of a baboon face, you know, but I thought, yeah, screw that bullshit. And also in the studio, it's quite dark. So yeah, let's get serious. Right now, the video you're about to see is an edit from a live stream I do on Facebook. I'm trying to do it every Thursday at 7 p.m., but it is what it is. It doesn't always work out. So this video is about distorted snares, like how to make like out of an acoustic snare sample with some synths and all that type of shit and distortion or whatever. So how to make that type of distorted industrial type of snare. I mean, you know what I'm talking about. You use them, you made them, and you heard them, so it's all cool. The video itself is quite long and quite boring, but you might want to look into it. There are some techniques you might didn't see before. And before we get started, go on my YouTube channel and subscribe to the channel and also activate the notifications button so you get a notification if a new video is up. And also the same thing, you can head over to my Facebook /generalguyble and also like the page and also activate this kind of follow thing so you see the posts. Because you might wanna tune in for the next live streams. Sometimes we talk about pretty serious behind the scenes type of shit. And also I show some techniques which aren't really made for the public. So they never gonna appear on those type of videos. It's just a one-time thing, it's happening live. After that live stream, the video is gonna get deleted and nobody will ever see it again unless, you know, somebody's recording his screen. But I'm sure nobody's crazy enough to do that type of shit. So long story short, enjoy that video, and you know, if you like it, leave me a comment, and yeah, I hope I hear from you soon. Bye bye.
Snares, it's quite interesting. You can do a lot of stuff, especially with this acoustic snares. One thing would be, for instance, distorted. If you do the cueing right before, you can get interesting snares. Like that, it kind of develops a tonality, and you can play around with your distortion. What's also interesting are the Farman shifters. Frequency shifter. So that one, you can kind of pitch the low end but still keep it normal. Keep the character of the high end and transient. To even extend it a little bit more. I found all the tube work really nice. See, now we got like a very ringing sound. Probably it shouldn't be that low. There you go. kind of idea what to do with it, but let's bounce it out for now. Actually, I wanted to make a different type of snare. That's how I would make like those, yeah, those type of the industrial snares. And then of course you would start layering it up, get a more clean pump, find the right balance. So it wouldn't harm to reduce those frequencies again. They are kind of cool when you distort them. But see, once you got the character, you don't really need to overdo them too much. And out of curiosity, we can even put in a tuner. See if that finds a pitch on that one. Personally, I'm not a big fan of that, but I know a lot of guys really tuning their snares and all that type of stuff. I don't really see the point based on the structure of how the snare is done. But why not? So we set up the bass on a how's it called, that thing, on the operator of the kick. We set it up on F, so probably we're gonna try to pitch that one on C. So we got like this fifth. I don't know if it's the fifth in English, but you get the idea. Something like 17 down. So now I got to calculate a little bit, but let's go with minus 30, then it should be in place. Yeah, pretty much. And you also see here, it's kind of jumping between F and C. It's, yeah. Because of the distortion that introduced harmonics, that's one of them. So let's actually find the attack of that one. Yeah, that one doesn't have an attack. Yeah, actually I wanted to make like a standard kind of drum and bass, you know, breakbeat snare, but yeah, let's make a distorted one first and then we see if anybody is interested in seeing more. Awesome. I was saying that actually I wanted to make like a regular drum and bass snare, but now we got like this tone. So let's try to make something out of that maybe. First of all, let's see if we can sort of shorten it up. Definitely gonna leave some space here for some proper attack. compress it really, really hard. So what we've done now is we really emphasized the attack. As you can see, there's like this very peak in the beginning. It was much louder before and the peak was also there, but now it's a little bit more emphasized. And now we're gonna push it and eliminate that peak. Like the peak is now much lower in volume, but the kick is, the snare is not that much lower. And here it comes in with zero, but it goes out with minus 10. So we gain. Now we can use another sort of a clipper. Let's leave it there for now. I mean, you're not gonna go far with that snare alone. First of all, we can add another layer for the, you know, the chest. What I said already a couple of times today. Pretty much same thing as before. Just like this. So let's set it up on C. Sometimes you have to watch. Yeah, now you should go really crazy and tune everything. Let's see if the settings which I got on the EQ will still match. Some pretty slight movement. Okay, a little bit more. crunch. Okay, let's see how they go together. So that's a good thing. Now you cannot really tell it's there, but you can tell if it's not there anymore. Sound is aggressive and noisy as fuck. I mean, that distorted snare. So let's use the same one again. As we figured out, we have to pitch it by 2, or if you want to pitch it down at least. Let's try to distort that one as well. Maybe before. That's where you get a little bit of punch on top of that layer. Got the feeling it needs an EQ after all that. Sometimes also some downsampling. Can add some nice frequencies. Right. Good way to bring them together. Like compress them really hard. Let's see. For now, of course, yeah, I always need a little bit of change, so I always change up the plugins I'm using. And lately, I discovered back this Renaissance bundle. Even though I swore to myself I'm never gonna buy Waves plugins again and not gonna use them anymore. Just keep them to open old projects, because yeah, their upgrade policy is a pain in the ass. I think like every time I buy a new computer, I want to upgrade them, and then I got to buy a new license. So I bought this pack probably already 5 times, but still nice plugins though. So I'm really not encouraging people to crack them, but you know, with that upgrade policy. Yeah, if I didn't have them, I might consider it. And on top of that, if I, you know, I don't use cracks, told it already. Not anymore. I would be lying if I say I never done that. Anyway, back to topic. Again, I'm repeating myself, but not 100% there yet. And let's try this nice convolution reverb from Max for Life. Oh, what the fuck? What's it called? I thought it was called convolution reverb. Oh, my bad. Not a native speaker, so sometimes it happens, you spell shit wrong. They got like all this really, really nice recasty and all that type of shit, so it's pretty cool. Let's try a snare plate maybe. Not really what I'm looking for. And I purposely put it before the compressor, but we can also see how it sounds afterwards. Because if you compress the shit out of it, they also start interacting together, and sometimes it's very nice. Let's say the attack is almost too clean. Maybe I'll leave a very short piece just for the initial transient. Some solution for the transient. Yep, now we can squash the shit out of it because the transient is very loud. And that all happens without losing too much. How does it look like? Probably can afford to lower them all a little bit. pre-delay could be better. My video zone again to finalize it. So what I would do here is first thing, I don't even think I need compression, but the same thing I did with the exciter before would be probably appropriate here as well. Just fatten it up a bit. Like a linear phase, doesn't really mess with your phase, which is good. I also want to find that sweet spot. Let it ring a little bit more. And let me. This limiter is pretty amazing. But I'm gonna put a vintage limiter before, which is not too fast. But that's too slow, so if I hear it back, I don't hear it like I will bounce it or record it there. Okay, and then we're gonna squash it from here. Let's see how the waveform looks like. Yes, I thought transient is already pretty squashed, but it still sounds alright. But what I wanna do is push the tail more and do a little bit less of limiting. Changes, we also already lost again a little bit of the punch, but it's fine, I guess. Also some side hand. Just wanna put the ringing frequency more on the side. be one snare. Do we got anything else here? Let me get rid of that one. Okay, the left right doesn't seem accurate. That's probably due to the mid side and also the reverb. Let me bounce one thing off without reverb. Yeah, same shit. But good to have one with and one without.